This is MD Barkat Hassan. Welcome to my new blogs. Today my guest is Mr. Kenat. He is International Student Admission Officer, Hanlyo University. Welcome to sir my shows. And
thank you so much. My name is Kenneth, as usual, as he introduced me very well. I'm an admission officer at the International Office at Hanlyo University. Very fantastic and fabulous university. Thank you for hosting me, and I hope to have a great day today. Thank you so much, sir. Yes.
Sir, how long have you been in Korea?
Oh, probably I have been in Korea for almost 5 years and a few months. And I have stayed here in Hanlyo University particularly. It's 1 year. But the rest of the years, I have been working in different colleges and universities before coming here. Thank you.
That's great.
Yes.
Sir. Sir, what is the challenges did you face in Korea? When you came to Korea, did you face any challenges?
Well, thank you so much. It's a great question as well. And actually, I would wish all our viewers on this channel really to reflect on that matter. By the first time when I arrived in Korea, I came with a student visa, which was a Korean language visa, D4. And it was a little bit strange because of different culture, because of different environment, because of different everything. And even the standard level of the country, including the standard level of my home country, was totally different. So in that matter, I faced a big challenge of transportation, a big challenge of the language. The language was a little bit very difficult, and a big challenge of food as well. The food was a little bit spicy and so on, but with time I get used with it. Then I face a challenge of living status, living style. Living style, everything was in apartments. In our countries, we normally live in commercial homes, but here it was apartments, everything is included inside. It was a little bit very great challenge for me. That's why I say it was a challenge. But main major, it was Korean language. So that's why I came to study Korean language. I studied very hard and I concentrated it to know how they communicate in society, to know how I can take the bus, to know how I can use the subway. And most especially for ordering food in the restaurants, it was quite a little bit tragic. Sometimes they don't speak English in restaurants very much. And when I enrolled Korean language, I enrolled it in the village, something like that. So that was the main challenge, Korean language. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Sir, as I know, you came from African country.
Yep.
So, have you ever feel any racism in Korea?
Oh, well. In Korea, there is not that much racism like the people they think, or the people they understand that Korea, they think that Korea has racism. But to me, I never saw any racism. Of course, the racism, every country has racism. But in Korea, it's quite a little bit less. The reason being, one, in African countries, some of the Korean people who are already, I think, 50s, they have never met African people. But they don't see as a racism. They see as curious. Oh, Africa? Oh, you're from Africa? Yeah, I'm from Africa. Oh, nice to meet you. Africa, which side? Something like that. But that's not a racism. Racism in Korea is very less.
Yes,
yeah,
yes, right.
To be honest, it's very less.
So what are the benefits as an international student in Korea?
Oh, great. The benefits are actually it's a huge, there is a lot of benefits for international students. One, if you study from Korea and you get the degree from Korea, it means you are entitled to find a job in Korea. Because in Korea, it's an industrial company, rather an industrial nation, which has many companies and factories and so on. So those companies, they are looking marketeers export department. So if you have a degree in Korea, it's very easy and comfortable to find a job. Another thing, we need to fight to understand a little bit Korean language, if you know the basic Korean language. So it's very easy for it to find a job. That's whom I think, if you study in Korea and you have a degree in Korea, you have a lot of opportunity to find a job. And another thing, if you get a degree in Korea, it is easier for you to find further education in European countries as PhD or masters and so on.
It's really great.
That's right.
Yeah. what could be the future international student in Korea?
Oh yeah, well, thank you so much. The future of international students in Korea, it's a range information for that. For example, some students here who are studying in Korea, they aim to study and graduate masters. For instance, me, I graduated masters here in Korea, but after graduation masters, I found a job in other universities. I told you I have been living here for 5 years and a few months.
Yeah.
I have spent 5 years with working universities. Wow. My first university was Yongin University, second university was Yewan University, third university is Hanlyo University. So which means I have earned a degree here,
yeah.
And it is so easy for me to communicate and to use the degree I achieved from here to go in the market and fight with the job hunting with Korean nationals as well. And I got a job. So for that matter, students who study from here, they have a big opportunity to acquire jobs and stay. And for that matter, there is another chance for international students. Once you are an international student here, you graduate PhD. Allow me to put this one on your channel. If you are an international student here, graduate master's and graduate PhD, you are entitled to apply permanent residence in Korea. There is quite F5-27. It is called permanent residence visa for specifically those who graduated PhD here and master's together as well. So there is that opportunity as well. Those who would love to stay in Korea. But those who would love to graduate master's in Korea and apply European countries for their further studies, it's a great opportunity. There is much opportunity for that matter.
Wow.
Thank you.
That's great.
Mm.
So as an international student, every international student who have completed their graduation from Korea in university, they have opportunity for their permanent resident or citizenship, I think.
Yes. Absolutely. Yes. They do have that opportunity because the government value international students on the different ways. If you graduate, for instance, you graduate in engineering in Korea, master's and PhD, so you are really, really entitled to acquire permanent residence here with the certain documents.
Wow.
Yes.
That's great.
Yeah.
Thank you guys, everyone. And please keep watching my channel and please subscribe my channel and comment below on the video. Thank you guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much.